International Financial Management video lecture series. Today we'll discuss about how to identify a quote as a direct quote as well as indirect quote. Let's have a look at the slide where we have displayed the problem, read the problem, and then we'll go to the solution of that particular problem. The problem is like this: identify whether the quotes are direct or indirect provided by the SBI Chennai. Also, provide the corresponding quote for the whether it's direct or indirect one. So, we have set of questions are there here. Six questions are there. We'll solve one by one. The first one is Hong Kong dollar 1 is equal to rupees 5.50. Hong Kong dollar 1 is equal to rupees 5.50. Now, how to identify whether the quote is direct quote or indirect quote? Whenever a quote has been expressed in terms of one unit of foreign currency, then those quotes we call it as a direct quote. Okay. So, then it is a, what is this? This is a direct quote. This quote, what they are given is direct quote. Now, how to identify, how to write the indirect quote for that or corresponding quote for that? If you express one unit of home currency is equal to how many units of foreign currency, that we call it as a indirect quote. Okay, so here the answer is, if you divide 1 by 5.50, the answer what we get is 0.18818. This is the indirect quote. If you express 1 rupee is equal to, or 1 unit of home currency is equal to how many units of foreign currency, then we call it as a indirect quote. In the same way, second quote is like this: rupee 1 is equal to rupee 1 is equal to yen 0.10. So now we have to identify which quote it is, whether it is a direct quote or a indirect quote. When we express in terms of home currency, then we call that as a indirect quote, correct? So now the quote is which quote? Indirect quote. So now how to write the direct quote for this? So for that we have to express in a one unit of foreign currency. 1 yen is equal to 1 divided by 0.10 will become a direct quote. So answer is 5.2632. Okay. In the same way, the third problem is one pound is equal to rupee 83.50. Hope all of you understanding, right? 1 pound is equal to rupees 83.50. Now you can guess it, right? So it is expressed in one unit of foreign currency. So it has to be direct quote. Now for this direct quote, we have to write the indirect quote. So if it is indirect quote, means we have to express in one unit of home currency. 1 rupee is equal to 1 divided by 83.50. If you solve for this, will it answer as pound 0.0120. This is the answer for this. Now in the same way, we have few more questions. Fourth one is rupee 1 is equal to euro 0.0175. okay, so this has been expressed in terms of when we express in term for home currency, it has to be the indirect quote. When we express in terms of home currency, that has to be indirect quote. Now to express in terms of foreign currency, 1 euro is equal to 1 divided by 0.0175. So how much we'll get? 57.1429. Okay. So 1 euro is equal to rupees 57.1429. The fifth one is Malaysian ringgit 1 is equal to rupees 12.50. Okay. So this expressed in terms of foreign currency, one unit of foreign currency. So it has to be a direct quote, correct? So corresponding quote for this is 1 rupee is equal to 1 divided by 12.50. So how much it comes to? 0.08. So Malaysian ringgit 0.08. So then the last one is N1 is equal to rupees 0.35. This is expressed in terms of one unit of foreign currency. Whenever we express in terms of one unit of foreign currency, it has to be called as direct quote. So for this corresponding quote is 1 rupee is equal to how much N? So it comes to, the answer comes to 2.8571. So friends, so in this session what we discussed about how to identify a quote as a direct quote as well as indirect quote. And once we identified, what we did, we found out the corresponding quote. If it is direct quote, we found the indirect quote. If it is indirect quote, we found the direct quote. In the next video, we'll discuss about, here we have only one bid rate. In the next video, we'll discuss about the, when we have bid and ask rate, how to identify the direct quote as well as indirect quote. Thank you.